Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to eliminate render blocking resources on WordPress. If you've ever run your WordPress site through Google PageSpeed Insights, Google has probably told you that you need to eliminate render blocking resources on your WordPress site. In fact, I'd venture to guess that's why you're watching this video right now. But before we get started, I'd like to invite you to subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's eliminate those render blocking resources already. You won't have to do this manually. We'll talk about WordPress plugins that can help you eliminate render blocking resources here in a minute. However, it is helpful to understand what these plugins are doing behind the scenes to eliminate render blocking resources. When Google tells you to eliminate render blocking resources, it's essentially saying, hey, don't load unnecessary resources at the top of your site's code because it's going to make it longer for your visitors' browsers to download the visible part of your content. When referring to render blocking resources, we're usually talking about CSS and JavaScript. It's important to understand that not all CSS and JavaScript files are render blocking. For example, it's important to load your critical CSS near the top. Otherwise, your visitors might experience what's known as a flash of unstyled content. Are images render blocking resources? No, images are not render blocking. It's still important to optimize your images to reduce their file sizes, but you do need to worry about optimizing the delivery path for your images. There are a few different strategies to eliminate render blocking JavaScript, but here are the main methods. Async. This lets the HTML parser, such as a visitor's browser, download the JavaScript while still parsing the rest of the HTML. That is, it doesn't completely stop parsing while the file downloads. However, it will pause the HTML parser to execute the script once it downloads. Defer. This lets the HTML parser download the JavaScript while parsing the rest of the HTML and waits to execute the script until the HTML parsing is finished. This illustration from Growing with the Web does a great job of showing the difference. The benefit of using defer is that your scripts are guaranteed to execute in the order that they appear in the code. Async does not use this approach, which can sometimes cause issues if you apply async to all JavaScript resources because it can often break resources that are dependent on resources that appear earlier in the document. The most common problem async produces is broken jQuery resources that try to load before jQuery.js has been added to the document. Eliminating render blocking CSS can be a little trickier because you have to be careful not to delay CSS that is needed to render above the fold content. The ideal arrangement is to first identify the styles that are required to render above the fold content and deliver those styles in line with the HTML. Then, use the media attribute on the link elements that pull in CSS files to identify CSS resources that are conditional, that is, only needed for specific devices or situations. And finally, any remaining CSS resources should be loaded asynchronously, a move that is typically done by adding them with deferred or asynchronous JavaScript. To be honest, we're really getting in over our heads here, aren't we? This is definitely front-end engineer territory, which is great if you're a front-end engineer, but most of us aren't. The good news is that this video is about WordPress, and you can eliminate or at least significantly reduce the number of render blocking JavaScript and CSS resources affecting your site with the right plugins. To demonstrate how to eliminate render blocking resources on WordPress with plugins, we set up a simple test site that includes render blocking CSS and JavaScript, and then we'll take you through how to use two different plugin solutions to eliminate the render blocking CSS and JavaScript. Autoptimize, an async JavaScript, a free paid plugin, and WP Rocket, a paid plugin. For reference, here's what our test site looks like before optimizing CSS and JavaScript delivery. If you're testing the effectiveness of your changes with Google PageSpeed Insights, be aware that Google caches its results for several minutes. Essentially, this means that if you quickly test your unoptimized site, activate one of the plugins in this section, and reset your site, then you'll see the results of your unoptimized site until Google resets its cache. So make sure you wait a few minutes for Google to clear its cache before you jump to the next conclusion that the plugin isn't working. Autoptimize and Async JavaScript are two separate free plugins from the same developer. Together, they help you optimize the delivery of both your CSS and JavaScript. Once you've installed both plugins, go to Settings and then Async JavaScript and check the box to enable async JavaScript at the top. Then choose between Apply Async and Apply Defer in the Quick Settings box. If the async option causes problems on your site, we'd recommend trying Defer or Excluding jQuery, which the plugin gives you an option for. Once you set up the Async JavaScript plugin, go to Settings and then Autoptimize and check the box to optimize JavaScript code and then check the box to optimize CSS code. If you're an advanced user, you can play around with the additional JavaScript and CSS optimization settings, but most sites will be fine with the defaults. After configuring Autoptimize and Async JavaScript, our test site passed PageSpeed Insights Eliminate Render-Blocking Resources audit. If you wanted to eliminate even more of those files, you could further use Autoptimize to manually inline your critical CSS. This requires some development knowledge, so it's not something non-developers should try. You can also try the plugins separately if preferred, but given that both plugins come from the same developer and are built to play nice with each other, the best approach for most sites is to combine them. WP Rocket is a popular premium WordPress performance and caching plugin. Normally, we don't allow caching plugins on WordPress sites hosted at Kinsta because we already handle caching for you at a server level via the speedy Nginx Fast CGI cache. However, WP Rocket has a special integration with Kinsta that lets WP Rocket play nice with your Kinsta caching. That's great because WP Rocket does a lot more for WordPress performance than just caching, including what we're here for today, helping you eliminate render-blocking CSS and JavaScript resources on your WordPress site. Once you install and activate WP Rocket, go to the File Optimization tab. Then, enable these two options: Optimize CSS Delivery under the CSS File section, and Load JavaScript Deferred under the JavaScript File section. You can experiment with turning the safe mode for jQuery off, but if you notice problems on the front end of your site, you'll want to re-enable safe mode for jQuery as it's likely the culprit. After activating these two features, our test site also passes the Eliminate Render Blocking Resources audit in PageSpeed Insights. WP Rocket also managed to eliminate more render blocking resources than the Autoptimize and Async JavaScript setup. There you have it. That's how to eliminate render blocking resources on your WordPress website. Do you have any additional questions about how to eliminate render blocking resources on WordPress? Let us know in the comments below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.